This has been News Center 31. Depend on us to keep you informed.
I think the responsibility is something that you can't shirk. It's something that you want. You know, I'm an Italian boy from a family of five children in the family. And I asked my mother one time, you know, why aren't we a closer family than some other families that I see? And she said, well, that's easy to explain. She said, I raised a family of five leaders. Aren't any followers, and so it's a natural thing. If you win, there is such a great natural high because of the total involvement, the amount of immersement that you have in this business. To have it all culminate in those kids playing well and playing together and playing unselfishly, you know, and then representing your school and your community. And I really would like to have this program knocking on the door of the top 20, and that's always been my goal. So, considering all these factors, where you want to go, what you want to do, your long-range goals, your short-term goals, positioning in the conference, positioning for a tournament, the solving of the little problems that surface, the jealousies, you know, who starts, who doesn't start, the pettiness, the reducing of all of that into one kind of unified effort on game day to win that game and then win that game is an incredible and great natural high, one of the greatest feelings in the world. And I think it's what keeps a lot of people in this business.
Game Day with Dick Versace is brought to you in part by John Beers Ford Subaru in Washington, the price leader, and by Friends of Dick Versace.
Boy, this camping trip was a great idea.
Yeah, even if it's in John Beers' car.
What's that?
The Slasher.
The Slasher!
A creature who stalks Beers' car lot, slashing thousands of dollars off the price of top quality used cars and trucks.
What's that?
It's a Slasher!
Hey guys, where you going? I'm slashing prices on the greatest selection of used cars in town.
John Beers Ford Subaru. Everything you've always wanted in a used car truck for less.
Good evening and welcome to Game Day with Dick Versace. Tonight, Bradley plays Southern Illinois at the Civic Center, and the fans going to the game or listening on WMBD will see all the action. But Dave, tonight, they'll see much, much more.
Dick, looking forward to the game tonight, of course, and welcome to the program. Tonight, we're going to show you things that you probably have never seen before. We're going to take you behind the scenes with Bradley Basketball, give you a different look at the game. And it starts much before game day itself.
The preparation for the Saturday game with Creighton begins early in the week, Monday. Dick meets with associate coach Tony Baroni and assistants Rudy Keeling and Brad Dunn. Strengths and weaknesses discovered in the first game are discussed, all to have the team practice a game plan that'll hopefully be effective.
Okay, guys. The Blue Jays. Tony, you want to start? Give us a little overview.
All right. As opposed to the last game, they're starting Morris in place of Grappato. And it gives them some more outside shooting.
How much is Grappato playing?
He's still playing 18 to 20 minutes a game.
So Morris is playing the other 20.
And they're rotating in Johansson, a freshman, playing a little bit. They like Morris's outside shooting.
Well, I would suggest, Rudy, that either you or Brad, you know, make sure that you get Jimmy in here and you get the whole team in here between the next 2 days and have them look at the Creighton film. Now, Bruce came in this morning, right?
Right.
Did anyone else come in?
No. They're pretty booked class-wise today, though. In the morning.
How about this afternoon?
Open. Pretty much open.
Okay. Why don't we see if we can at least get half done today and then get the other half done
okay. Tomorrow.
See,
we need to talk to Boise because he's going to have some preconceived notions about going into this game in terms of what he can do against Creighton. He had a ton of corner shots against them.
Now who guarded him last time?
Grappato. Yeah.
And we can't have a good stretch run here if he can't get that concept. You told me yesterday you thought he was playing too fast again. I agree. But it's hard to discourage a guy from, you know, working hard. He's working hard. He wants to win. He's just as, you know, he's confused here about how to do it. And I'm not sure what the answer is after 4 years with him to make him understand that. He's improved in so many areas that, you know, it's hard to fault him. You know, I look at him and I see the kid is really trying, you know, and he's performed well for us. Let's just get involved with coaching these kids down the stretch here and seeing, let's take the attitude now that they're not rookies anymore. Let's take the attitude that they're veterans. They do truly have experience now. They've seen a lot of situations. Some of the tests have failed, some of the tests have passed. And I think they've got enough of a backlog of positive experiences where if we can build their confidence levels, okay? So I want to reduce the amount of negativism, you know, in the way we talk to them, in the way we criticize them. And let's keep the practices high-spirited and keep the intensity level up. But let's do it with positive input. That's about it. Anything else, Tony? You want to bring anything else up?
No.
Okay. All right. Let's get the kids in for the film session this afternoon. Okay.
The bond of the pregame meal, that's got to be about the closest time because you've got everybody's got a common goal, you've worked. This is kind of the lull before the storm. Special time.
It is a special time. We established that. I guess I learned from my second collegiate experience when I was at Michigan State. Gus Kanakis was a Greek. And you know how the Greeks are. I mean, he was like the original Zorba. You know, I almost expected that we would, at these team meals, put our arms around each other and do the dance and everything. But Gus was very good at that, at bringing people together. He was a very loving person. But I took those good qualities, I think, that I saw him display in the positive effects that he had on kids. And use some of those techniques when I came to Bradley here. And the pregame meal is a special time for us. It's gotten a little more lighthearted than it did during the Anderson Reese Thurkill era. They were kind of always kind of very serious in those pregame meals. And I didn't know if that was that good. But this group is so young, they don't know how they're supposed to act. And they're not, I think in time that the pregame meal, you know, as they are together for more years, will become a more serious event for them. So I do not get involved in any of the details once the pregame meal is over. Any of the nuts and bolts types things, like, you know, getting the fans, getting the players down to the game, making sure that they're taped at the proper time, that's all handled by my assistants. So I arrive at the game later than they do. I arrive usually about an hour and 15 minutes before the game. Go out and like to see some people, just shake some hands and say hello and be available to the public at that time. And, you know, sign some autographs, talk to some little kids, just stuff like that. And be seen and just kind of chat and just be relaxed. All the while churning, you know, upstairs about, you know, the impending game. And then I'll go in and I'll speak with them. Usually the talk that I give to them prior to the warm-up is more detailed and more scientific than the talk that I give them prior to going out on the floor to play. This year we have a chaplain on the team, and he's been a big help to us. He's really helped this team of young kids stay together. He's been available to them for any problems that they might have. We say a prayer before the games, and whether he's there or not. One of the captains will lead the prayer, you know, circling and holding hands. I think it's a really nice thing. It's really kept this team together.
Are you a Newt Rockne type?
Depends on the kids. This is not a group of kids that I've been Newt Rockne with. I was Newt Rockne on occasion with the Reese Anderson Third Kill group because they really responded to that. I think you have to kind of read your kids.
Okay, don't forget it.
Ready to go.
Okay. Now, I told you at the beginning of the week when I came back from Philadelphia and joined you on Wednesday that we were going to pick up our intensity level. All the things that you do well, you're going to do harder, longer, and you're going to not give yourself any excuse. No set of circumstance. You're going to feel about yourself today that you got lots of energy to burn, and you got a lot of bravery in your heart and your body. And you're going to take the charge like we haven't done before. And you're going to go down for loose balls. And you're going to go after every rebound. We're not going to catch somebody standing and not going. And you're going to get yourself in double figures and fulfill your promise. We're going to have our head in our game. And you're going to play like you used to play, too. Because you have been on a little slump yourself. And your attitude against everyone you play is that they're in your way for where you want to go. Do the right things to get there. Let's go.
Pretty much the last minute thoughts I have are what defense we're going to open in, since we are a ball club that plays a variety of defenses. Pretty much once we get into that hoopla part, I just try to back off out of the limelight and let the kids enjoy that part. I think all the hard work that they do, a lot of it is for that moment that they get up to run through the tunnel there and do a lot of high-fiving and get the cheers from the crowd and the thrill of a start.
When the weather turns your basement into a wet, ugly mess, fight back with basement dewatering. Basement dewatering removes unwanted water permanently during any season of the year. Our trained professionals have developed a powerful system that is placed only at the trouble spot where the wall meets the floor. And it can be installed in a finished or unfinished room, so your basement is guaranteed to stay water-free. Fight back with basement dewatering. Call today for a free estimate. Basement Dewatering, Central Illinois' largest dewatering company.
Boy, this camping trip was a great idea.
Yeah, even if it's in John Bierce's car.
What's that?
The Slasher.
The Slasher!
A creature who stalks Bierce's car lot, slashing thousands of dollars off the price of top quality used cars and trucks.
What's that?
It's a Slasher!
Hey guys, where you going? I'm slashing prices on the greatest selection of used cars in town.
John Bierce Ford Subaru. Everything you've always wanted in a used car truck for less.
Hey, Mr. Versace, want some kitchen cooked potato chips?
Nah, no thanks, kid.
But they're the greatest, Mr. Versace, just like your team.
Hey, you're all right, kid.
Thanks, coach.
Kitchen cooked potato chips are kettle cooked for a hearty potato flavor the whole family will enjoy.
And I wouldn't do this commercial if I didn't eat kitchen cooked potato chips. They're the greatest.
Kitchen cooked potato chips and snacks, available at your grocer's.
In the past 2 years, their volunteers helped weatherize almost 1,000 homes of people like us who need help, and they did it free. Their shareholders gave $150,000 to help pay utility bills for people who couldn't pay. Why, just last year alone, they helped folks get over $400,000 in low-interest loans for energy improvements, and continued gas and electric service to nearly 5,000 families in financial trouble. Maybe something to think about the next time you see their name.
As the game begins, it's apparent early that Willis Reed intends to go to Big Benoit Benjamin. At the other end, the shots are there for Boise winners. And as in game one, he's Bradley's offense in the first half.
Here, let's go high 1-4. Boise, I want to take a look at you on the inside first, okay? So you'll be inside with Donald, all right? Then we got Hawk and Jimmy. And Timmy, you played a point, all right? Don't forget to step and go high 1-4. All right, now, Boise, what you got to do is do some flashing in there, okay? And we'll try and do some posting up, all right? So you got to get into the middle and try to get yourself open in here. Keep working and don't get frustrated. All right, let's go. You got to do it on defense.
Combo, Dick?
Yeah. Hey! Hey! You're in combo here! Jimmy! You'll be in combo! Two! Two right here, and then we're gonna go to combo on the inbound.
Donald!
guys down the baseline, either Jimmy or Hawk. So get them in a high 1-4. You know how to do it, don't you?
Yeah.
All right, good job.
Hard to go from red to the 3-2.
Is it? 3-2 has neutralized Ben a little
bit. Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
We got it. Let's go.
Jimmy. Stick him in now. We're going to stay right in this thing, baby. We're staying right in this thing.
6-2, we got it down 7, let's go!
Timmy, you're really helping us. You're really helping us on defense. But on offense, you're turning the ball over. You know, you just like, how many TOs has he got? Three, and then maybe two shots that no way they're going down. So that's half a dozen, see? Can you control that? Now, Hawk, you got to do a better job on Swain. At one time, he had the ball at the top of the key, took two slow dribbles to 15 feet and shot a wide-open jumper. You got to step with the dribbler and turn the dribbler back. You should be able to tie that kid into knots. You got to get some tenacity on him. You got to make it hard for him to do anything out there. You got to frustrate him, and then he'll take some bad shots. Okay. Let's review it. I like the combo, okay? So let's go. We're going to go red to combo. Timmy, you got to watch your turnovers now, okay? Offensively, we need, on our trips down, we need shots, okay? So watch your turnovers, but still play aggressively. Now, you're down 7 in this game. Is that what we're down?
9.
You're down 9. Whose possession? Theirs?
Their ball.
Okay. You need a good D stop this first time. Then cut it to 7 and we'll start chipping away. Okay? You want to stay aggressive and keep your intensity levels up defensively. All right. 2 minutes. Let's go, fellas. Let's go. Come on, let's go. Come on.
Let's go.
Defense. Yeah.
Let's go.
Or you can run 52s, then come back and set the up screen and pop off the up screen. All right, defense. Let's hold him here.
Let's go, Michael. Go to work on it, baby.
Here's now Les. Explodes. They got a 3-on-1 break. Jimmy leads. Come on! Twice the winner. Here's a steal. Bankston with a steal. It's tied. The inbounds pass to Bankston. 9 seconds on the shot clock. 8 on the shot clock. Bankston out of the Hawk. Drives in the lane. Off the glass. It rims. No good. No good. They got a foul. No basketball. Now with 11. Bankston with 10. Now to Winters with 8. Up front is Bankston with 6. Now with 5. Winters with 4. 25-footer short. Rebound taken out Benjamin. And that's overtime at the Civic Center this afternoon.
And I thought the kids that played the bulk of the minutes really did a proud job of battling back time after time. And we had a shot to win it. And we didn't get a very good shot for 35. And when we got the fresh 45, we just didn't get a very good shot there. And I think that was our chance to win it because we were really in serious foul trouble. So we had you can't fault the kids. They did a great job. They got down. They fought back. Every time they got down, they fought back. And they fought back and tied it and had a shot to win it and just weren't able to get it done. Our kids did a great job in the second half. I was really proud of them. Came back and shot 64% in the second half to their 43%. So that means that we were playing good defense and we were, you know, getting much better shots. And they had legitimate chances to win it. And you just got to be a man about it. I've been accused in my coaching career of not having lost enough to learn how. And in these last few years, I guess I'm mellowing some as far as what I think is a realistic effort from my kids. And I think I got a tremendous effort from them. And in view of the circumstances of the game and the way the game went, I don't know if I could have asked for much more. Walking off the court, I couldn't have asked them for much more. What else can I say?
Boy, this camping trip was a great idea.
Yeah, even if it's in John Bierce's car.
What's that?
The Slasher.
The Slasher!
A creature who stalks Bierce's car lot, slashing thousands of dollars off the price of top-quality used cars and trucks.
What's that?
Slasher!
Hey guys, where are you going? I'm slashing prices on the greatest selection of used cars in town.
John Bierce Ford Subaru. Everything you've always wanted in a used car truck for less. Nike Vandals. They're not for everyone.
Available at Michael Ulrich's Sports Corner.
Hey, Mr. Versace, want some kitchen cooked potato chips?
Nah, no thanks, kid.
But they're the greatest, Mr. Versace, just like your team.
Hey, you're all right, kid.
Thanks, coach.
Kitchen cooked potato chips are kettle cooked for a hearty potato flavor the whole family will enjoy.
And I wouldn't do this commercial if I didn't eat kitchen cooked potato chips. They're the greatest.
Kitchen-cooked potato chips and snacks. Available at your grocer's.
Energy costs got you tied down?
Then make improvements with a lift from Silco.
Lift. The low-interest loan with rates about a third less. Any homeowner can apply.
Lift means you can really start saving on energy costs in your home.
With things like high-efficiency heating and cooling equipment, furnace improvements and repairs, insulation and weatherization materials that'll pay you back with lower utility bills.
So get your energy improvements off the ground now with a lift from Silco.
So that's game day with Dick Versace. And Coach, thanks a lot for letting us inside the Bradley program. I think the program very informative and people learned a lot.
Well, David, there's a lot more to running a Division I basketball program than meets the eye. And it was a pleasure to have you and our viewing fans share what goes on behind the scenes.
I want to have a special thank you to Steve Tomlin, who followed you around on game day. Did a fine job.
Steve was easy to work with, and I'd like to thank him, too. He was one of the guys that got into my little secret hiding places, you know.
We got basketball tonight against Southern Illinois.
Yeah, and there's still time to get out and see the game.
And so if you can make it to the game, we'd like to have you there. If not, listen on WMBD Radio 1470. Game day with Dick Versace, an inside look at Bradley basketball. Hope you enjoyed the program. Hope you enjoyed tonight's game. So long, everybody.
Game days kind of vary. I kind of would like to have my game days be busy. Quite frankly, that was against a 6'6 man guarding. Now with Ben in there, it's going to be even more difficult. So I don't know if, and we pretty much hit from the perimeter against this team.
I basically think they're going to stay with what's been winning for them. They've been successful, and I don't think they're going to come up with any unique things.
Okay, want to be sign yours?
Yeah.
Pioneer Junior High. Did your team play here today?
Yeah.
Did you win?
No.
And you guys are still smiling?
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
What is that?
That's a 7. When it's a 1, it'll be 4 all the way down. When you see that, that's just a 7 or an 8 or whatever the single digit should be. But I want you to be aware of it.
All right, you got a full front. That's what you got to do. Full front.
Use your quicks.
Use your quicks. Don't let them get to your body now. Don't let them get to your body.
Jimmy.
All right, let's go. Want to go with a 53 here? Hey, he can put his hip on you, and that's history. Your history, right?
So there was physical contact. So if there weren't charges, then they had to be fouled. So if they're not called, then that's just the vicissitudes of this particular game. And from the effort that I got from these wonderful group of young kids, I guess, Mike, walking off the court, I couldn't have asked them for much more. What else can I say?
Game Day with Dick Versace was brought to you in part by John Beer Sports Subaru in Washington, the price leader.